Barrasso, the starting goaltender for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
What is a 15-5 and a 2.71 goals against average. He now has the top save percentage in the NHL in the playoffs, .911. Eddie Belfour, record of 12-4, 2.36 goals against average.
And the puck drop, Mario Lemieux out here with Kevin Stevens and Rick Tocchet, and the Penguins steer it up towards the Hawks line. In the first moments of play in game number four of the Stanley Cup final round.
You see Pierre McGuire with his hand on top of his head. Not because he doesn't have a lot of hair up there, but because he's signaling to his team that they have to make a line change. That's his hand signal to the guys on the ice that it's time to make a change.
And to Shale Samuelson, the Penguins whack it right back into the Chicago net area. Eddie Belfour leaves it near side. Yarmer, Yager, Maloney, and Trotty of the trio. Yager with a shot. He shoots and scores from the right wing circle. And the Penguins take a 1-0 lead. Oh, scratch my back with a hacksaw. What a vicious wrist shot by Yarmer Yager. And the Penguins take an early 1-0 lead here in Chicago.
First goal for Yager in the series since that tremendous goal he scored in the third period of game one. He just circled off the boards. Troy Loney made a beeline down the boards to pop the puck loose. Yager picked it up, walked out, and snapped it over the stick glove of Eddie Belfour. Yager does not pull the trigger that often with a wrist shot in that situation, but he had a lot of net to work with, and he put it in off the far post.
Number 11 in the playoffs for Yarmer Yager, and the Penguins have a 1-0 lead. He has not been able to score in this series. The Penguins have done a tremendous job against the big line. Loney knocking Ronick for a little loop there as Loney stepped into him. The play has stopped, and nothing will result here. Jeremy Ronick in the series has no points. Michel Goulet, the normal left winger on that line for quite a bit of time, has one goal, and Larmer has one assist. That's it.
Loney put the right arm on the back of Ronick and was able to push him down to the ice towards the boards in front of the Penguin bench.
To Chelios, and Chelios turns around, avoiding a check by Kevin Stevens, and on to Stephane Matteau. Right wing pass. Here's Graham into the Penguins. They come to the backhander. Stop. Rebound. Score. Kirk Graham got his own rebound back. And the Chicago Blackhawks have tied the game at one. I'll tell you, that was dangerously close to being an offside play there. But the Hawks get the tying goal. Dirk Graham finally gets one by Barrasso here in Chicago, and the Hawks have tied the game.
Barrasso stopped the first shot. The rebound came out and hit a skate or something, went right back into the net. I'd like to see that one again. Matteau, the man who made the play to him. Graham appeared to be way in
offensive
zone
when
he got it. Barrasso made the save. He got his own rebound and put it in. Good play by Graham, but he looked like he was 10 feet over the blue line when that puck was sent over the line by Matteau.
Well, I wish we had a different angle at it, but I do not believe, I just don't think he was onside. Here's Lemieux now, and Tocchet teaming up. Lemieux to the right side of Kevin Stevens, cuts around in on Buskas. Backhander, he shoots and scores! Kevin Stevens gets it right back. Oh, look out, Loretta! The Penguins have taken the lead, 2-1. Lemieux to Stevens, and the Penguins answer that goal, coming right back to cash in at 6:33, 12 seconds after Graham had scored.
And this off Mike Keenan's lips, Dominic. And here comes Dominic Hasek, the Czechoslovakian goaltender. Lemieux pushed it over, a little saucer pass to Stevens. He cut in on the backhand. Belfour was lunging for that puck again with a stick, and right through the five hole. He did not play that one at all. Belfour looking as if he's fighting the puck again. And that'll be all for him, at least for now. Keenan has been known to play musical goaltenders and send his goalies back in after pulling him in situations like this.
Now, Dirk Graham's goal for the Blackhawks, his fifth of the playoffs, second of the series at 6:21. Matteau assisting. That was at 6:21, and a dozen seconds later, Kevin Stevens notches his 13th of the playoffs. Mario Lemieux has one assist. Chelios also assisting on that goal by Graham. And the backhander by Stevens giving the Penguins the advantage again. And Dominic Hasek feeds his first action here in this series.
For years, Hasek was considered the best goaltender in Europe.
He has appeared in two playoff games this year. 0-1 with a 2.31 goals against average. And this young guy is going to come on for the Blackhawks.
He plays that butterfly style also. And he'll also put that stick flush to the ice, lay it down across his pads to block shots between the legs, and style is similar to Eddie Belfour's in that regard.
Hasek was an 11th round draft choice of the Blackhawks back in 1983 when it wasn't real fashionable to draft people. Now in front, here's Graham tying the game as he got open in front. And Dirk Graham gets his second, and we're off and running again. We're tied at two. Do you believe this? Three goals in less than a minute. Dirk Graham gets his second and his sixth of the playoffs, and it is 2-2.
The Hawks were looking for
30 seconds, three goals.
Mike Keenan thought that his team would be able to play a little looser here tonight and generate more offense. That was a good pass off the boards to Graham, and all he had to do was one time and into the net.
Move. Larry Murphy has it to the Chicago line. And Murphy's hit from behind by Chelios. A penalty coming up again. Chelios elbowed him. What's going on with Chelios? And Larry Murphy. Chelios just flattening from behind with an elbow. Blindsided him.
Goodness knocked gracious. Him out cold. He's out cold, I think.
Give me a break. Back, good drop pass to Murphy. A slap shot. Never got to the net. Now it's free in front. Score, Lemieux. He gives the Penguins a lead. Off Hasek, and Lemieux drills it home on the rebound. And the Penguins have a 3-2 lead. Goes back behind the net. Murphy, Austin in front. A good play by Justin Lemieux, but he can't beat Barrasso. Oh, an excellent play by Lemieux of the Hawks. What a front shot. Score. The hat trick for Dirk Graham. We're tied at three. Pretty pass out of the corner, and Dirk Graham right on the doorstep. Bangs it home as the Hats come on the ice here. We've got a 3-3 game in the first period.
Well, the Hawks said today that they wanted to get more plays side to side, making traffic in front of Tom Barrasso and also getting him to move from one post to the other. Plays going back and forth, and boy, they've been able to do that.
From him, but he lost it. Now Lemieux takes over, going to Tockett. Look ahead, Stevens behind the defense, walks in, got a chance, shoots. Oh, he missed the net. He had Hasek down, but he couldn't find the cage. I don't know if Hasek got a stick on that shot by Stevens or not. It just appeared that he shot it over the crossbar. Ulf Samuelsson of Pittsburgh on the play to Lemieux. Down the right wing, 2-on-1 with Tockett. Lemieux comes in. Tockett goes to the net. He's right in front of his backhander, but stick away by goaltender Hasek as he got that stick out, able to stick it away.
Just like we started at 7:42. That's the time they officially listed the game to start here, Chicago time. And we start the second period at 8:51, and it's a brand new game. It's 3-3.
The Chicago end. Drop pass to Kevin Stevens. In front, got a man talking, and he can't ram it home. Now Stevens in the corner, sends it right in front. Here's Tockett right there. He shoots and a score. The Penguins take the lead. Rick Tockett, I think, got it out the glove of Dominic Hasek. And the Penguins have regained the lead. They lead 4-3. And wristed back to the Penguin goal, and Barrasso will leave it for Gordy Roberts. Roberts could not get it out. Chelios in deep, put it in front of the center, and his shot on top of the stick of Barrasso. Made a key save on Brent Sutter there. Jagr's pass to Lemieux, one man to beat Steve Smith. Lemieux takes the puck into the Chicago and makes a move on Smith, comes down, backdoor pass to Stevens. Oh, what a save by Hasek on Kevin Stevens. That might be the save of the night as Dominic Hasek stopped Kevin Stevens on a brilliant move by Lemieux. Looking for Brian Noonan. Noonan, Gilbert on either side now for Jeremy Roenick. Gilbert comes on to Roenick, shooting in front, deflected in. The Hawks have tied it. Brian Noonan, it was off his body and a deflected by Barrasso. Tommy knew it immediately. He didn't even have to wait for the light to come on. I think it hit Noonan in the chest, or Noonan in the chest, and went in. The game is tied. Stevens finding Tockett. Lemieux wanting the puck, and he gives it to him at the Chicago line. But Kravchuk lost it now in front. Here's Lemieux. In on goal, his backhander stopped by Hasek. Great save again by Dominic Hasek on Mario Lemieux. And he gave more moves than Mae West on that one, but Hasek again continues to sparkle. This time Mario Lemieux. Now the Hawks come back on the rush, and here's Jocelyn Lemieux to the Penguins in. Right side of Graham. His shot blocked by Ulf Samuelsson. It comes around to Brian Noonan, left wing boards. Lemieux has had a couple of key chances against Dominic Hasek, but he has been spectacular in stopping Lemieux, particularly on the stick-hand side. Mario's going to have to give him a little different look. Here's Lemieux again. He got around Chelios. Knocked down, though. Feed it ahead to Stevens in a great play. Around Hasek, and Hasek challenges him to come out and knock it away. Dominic Hasek, another big goaltending effort to stop Kevin Stevens as Lemieux went diving to make the play to Stevens. And Dominic Hasek gambled and gambled right. And he does not allow Stevens a breakaway chance.
$100 worth of groceries and Kevin Stevens, a Redbirds goal scorer here in the third. So we begin the third period tied, as we have all periods so far. 0-0 to start the first, and then 3-3 at the end of one, 4-4 at the end of two. And immediately the Hawks are guilty of an offside play entering the Penguin zone. Dominic Hasek, who replaced Eddie Belfour after the Penguins scored their second goal. Can't hold on to it. And McEachran flies down the right wing into the Chicago zone. Drop pass to Jagr. Jagr in front. Got a man there. Francis backhander. Stop by Hasek, who made the save.
on Ronnie Francis on the backhand attempt, and Dominic Hasek is coming up tough in goal for the Chicago Blackhawks. Jaromir Jagr, who has not seen a lot of ice time in this game, but Jaromir has an ability to really turn the Jets on in the final period of regulation. And even looking further ahead, should it end up tied at the end of 60 minutes and then overtime too, because Jagr is that type of player, just seems to get stronger as the game goes along. No giving it.
Hasek only weighs 165 pounds and he's 5'11", so he's a skinny looking guy when you see him without his equipment on, and he almost looks like you could shoot the puck through him.
Actually, he's a normal looking person, let's put it that way.
Trottier look to get it to Jagr. Here he goes by one man. Kuchera down the right wing. Here's Jagr to the Chicago wind. Pulls around. Look, he still has the puck. Goes to Trottier. Shoots it. Hasek can save the rebound. Trottier right in front. Where is it? It's still loose. And Dominic Hasek comes up with it again. Off Samuelson defensively. Looking for Tocchet. Out ahead of Lemieux. Breakaway by Smith. Here he comes. Lemieux in on goal against Hasek. He shoots it. Hasek robs him again. Great balls of fire. Dominic Hasek throwing, stopping everything the Penguins are throwing at him. They've loaded up the big truck. They brought it into Chicago. And he's cleaning out all the sinks. He's making some fantastic saves. Lemieux trying to go up high, and Hasek said, not this time either. We'll be back 4-4 on the Penguins Hockey Network. And drop pass to Tocchet. As Murphy open, he's there. His shot went right over the crossbar. Larry Murphy won a game for the Penguins earlier this year on a similar type of shot. Here's Murphy again. Right wing circle. Fires it and he scores! The Penguins take the lead 5-4. Larry Murphy, I believe, will get the goal. And the Penguins have the lead again 5-4. Oh, call. Arnold Slick from Turtle Creek. Oh, boy. The Pens just kept pushing and pushing and pushing. And Larry Murphy shot it. I believe he'll get the goal. The go-ahead goal here in this hockey game in the third period by Larry Murphy. Here's Francis back now with McEachran 2-on-1. Francis comes in, shoots and scores! Ronnie Francis beats goaltender Hasek like a rented mule. He looked off and beat him on the short side, I believe. And the Penguins now lead 6-4.
Tell you, you learn from experience, and certainly he has enough of that. And here's Gribson now near side. Shooter right to that stop. Rebound in front, score!
The Hawks get a goal. Coming in 6-5. Jeremy Roenicke. Jeremy Roney comes up with his second goal of the game, and boy, he scores a goal when they need him the most to get him back within one. 1:02 to go, and they do not pull Hasek as the puck's back to center. Now onto the Penguin zone, and after a Goulet. Knocked down by Shel Samuelson. Tom Barrasso skates over to get the puck. The Penguins 53 seconds away. Hasek goes off the ice right now. They put the extra attacker on. It'll be Brent Sutter. Goulet and the Penguins in, trying to center. Behind the net it goes. Brent Sutter put it in front. Roney goes to the left point to Kravchuk of the Hawks. Now back in behind the net, the pass right up the boards to Barrasso, and he pulls it in with that glove and holds on with 39.3 seconds left in regulation. Cicelio steps up. He'll pass to Brent Sutter. Penguins lead 6-5. Roenicke with the puck into the Penguins in. Dance around one man. Shoots it, but he missed the net. 13 seconds left. Trottier golf it up. Lemieux's got the puck, and he can't get it out. Right in front of Flexen. Oh, what a save by Barrasso. Right up the play, and Goulet right in front. 5 seconds to go. Loose around to the far corner. 2 seconds. The Penguins are going to win the Stanley Cup, I believe. Stelio shoots it blocked. The Penguins have won the Stanley Cup. Oh, Lord Stanley. Lord Stanley, get me the brandy. The Pittsburgh Penguins have won the Stanley Cup. Mike Keenan shaking hands with Scotty Bowman. But the Penguins mob Tom Barrasso as they hold on. I'm telling you, it was that close to being a tie game. Goulet almost tied it for the Chicago Blackhawks as the Penguins celebrate behind the Penguin goal. Look at Tommy Barrasso, second straight year. Steve Lattin, the Pens equipment manager, hugging him. And Larry Murphy, a big squeeze in on Scotty Bowman. And I know somewhere, somebody looking down by the name of Badger Bob Johnson is watching this and enjoying it. They'll go for a skate here at the stadium in Chicago. They've got more wires out there than you could imagine. This is absolutely a great thrill. It really is, no matter if it happens once, twice, three, four, five times. Look at Scotty Bowman with a big smile, giving a great big hug to Rick Tocchet right now. And there goes Lemieux, carrying the Stanley Cup around. It'll come back to Pittsburgh.
And we will have a big day somewhere to celebrate this moment, believe me. And everybody in Western Pennsylvania, and if you're a Penguin fan from wherever you are invited to come down and be a part of the celebration.